Hey everybody, thanks for being here. This week we're in the mountains of Northern California on Lake Davis fishing for rainbow trout. Now if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf and this is Angler West Television. Lake Davis is low, but we can still launch to chase this lake's beautiful rainbow trout.
So we're launching out here at Lake Davis. It's up in the Portola Gray Eagle area. Going after some of these Eagle Lake trout. These things are about as close as you can get to Flaming Gorge kokanee, but obviously being rainbows, but it's supposed to be a good morning. We got high pressure built in and gonna give it a go. So we're heading over towards kind of the north side of the lake. We're gonna be fishing the north side of this island over here. There's a big channel and these fish seem like they're holding really well in that channel. And the ones that we're gonna see, we're gonna mark some down below, but the ones that are active are right on the surface.
Wiggle Hoochie's on here from a previous day of fishing, but gonna go ahead and pull it off. Go to something, it's even got a little bit more bright color to it, this green humdinger. Just thinking first thing in the morning here, get something a little bit smaller before we turn it up with the more aggressive lure later in the day.
To make it official, we gotta definitely get the clicker out. 21, that was the number yesterday. I think we actually pulled a couple more than that, but set at zeros. So these two rods, this one first off is the Angler West. It's a Talon rod, a little over 9 feet, 9 feet six. I'm gonna go ahead and run a orange and gold 1/8 ounce humdinger. I'm gonna go ahead and tip that with a little maggot, just to give it a little extra scent. No dodger, as you can see. It seems like less is more out here. And you know what? If they're gonna hit it without the dodger, that's just a little less drag that we have to fight coming in, even though the sling blades don't give much drag. We're gonna fill 100% fish on this for sure. So we're just gonna tip this with a little maggot. Pink is what I have. I don't think the color matters. It's more about scent. Something to kind of for them to key in. But so I got the maggot on there, but I'm also gonna put a little bit of this trophy trout bait sauce. This is just generally good on most lakes, but I'm just gonna put that right back in the trailer right there, right in the chamber. That'll disperse nicely and give a little extra scent. Again, this water is pretty clouded up right now, so scent is a huge factor. The second lure that we're gonna go ahead and put out, it's been really well, is this UV Crip lure. The benefit of UV in this cloudy water is, you know, that light penetrates, reflects off that UV. It's far more visible to these fish. We're gonna go ahead and send this. We're setting back about 200 feet or so. Long setbacks on these guys, longer the better. Get it away from the boat. But that fluttering action of that Crip lure, as the sun comes up, reflecting off that UV is gonna be pretty effective. It was one of our better lures yesterday.
Well, that one, we didn't see the rod hit, but we saw the fish jumping. Oh, rod two, Mark, we got a double here.
All right, both on Cripplers.
If we can manage to keep these babies apart.
So one lure that forgot to put out this morning did really well was the Crushed Fire Crip lure. So went in, took that 1/8 ounce orange humdinger off, put that Crushed Fire out, and it got hammered on. And then this one right here is a UV Crip lure. So we got a little bit of a,
you might want to come under me,
a little bit of a thing going on here. This is an okay fish, one that'll probably get released. So how's yours looking at him?
Not bad. He's taking a bit of drag, but he's nothing.
Yeah, I think he's a little bit better, so I'm going to let this one just sit with a little bit of drag. Get the net. Yeah, that's a good eater right there. I'll try and net this one as well. Take a look. I can release this guy both sides, actually. Let's say he cut up nice. So I'm just going to get this guy rolling in there.
Right here?
Yeah, he just inhaled that before. I don't think we would have been able to release them anyways.
Yeah. Well, we'll do glad to start the morning.
Yeah.
Nice work.
Boom, boom. Hey.
Oh, got four. Said double to start the morning. What I meant was triple.
Welcome back to Lake Davis. I'm Justin Wolf. We're not far from Portola, California, trolling for springtime rainbow trout that are good size, hard fighting, and great eating. And so far, the morning has started off with a bang.
Fun fight, these rainbows.
Typical size out here is about 16, 17 inches. You get to about 19, 20. There's probably some bigger fish than that, but 19 or 20 inches is a good size fish. Probably pushing 4 pounds, something like that. Big fat fish. This is kind of what happened yesterday. We just go through a school of fish, everything's quiet, and then it's just chaos. So this one's looking like it might be nicer. Yeah, it's holding down.
Yeah, he's got some weight. Thought he was strong enough to pull some drag there. We'll see if he's got another run in him here. Sometimes you get him right to the boat and then they just go for another spin around the block.
That's a nice fish.
Start shaking their head like that. They want to jump. Best to keep the rod tip down. Keep them in the water if you can. That's a little bit better fish.
That's a nice fish. It's probably pushing that 19-inch mark, I'd say.
He's not quite done yet. That's a nice one there. He might be ready to go right now.
There you go. Number three in the basket.
It's on that green humdinger there. Yeah, a little bit bigger fish.
19 and a half, maybe. That's a solid, solid Davis trout. And that'll cut up. The meat in this is just going to be bright red, much like kokanee. Some of the best eating trout in California. Go ahead and take these, put them right in the Yeti. Right on ice. Keep them nice and cold and be good table fare. Just can't forget to keep track of these fish. So there's three, quick three.
Typically, Davis is known for being a major bug lake. So that's, you know, why these fish get so fat. And also I believe they cut so red, the meat. So, you know, there's definitely some vegetation in the water. We'll start to see a bug hatch later. And these small humdingers and crip lures do a great job imitating bug kind of rolling and floating up through the water. Which is why I think they're so productive here at Davis.
So just putting these downrigger shallow, trolling speed, we try and keep it right around 1.9, 2 miles an hour. I mean, that's just a great speed for these crip lures, as well as the 8-ounce humdinger. So it's not too quick, but you know, the water's a little bit cold, but it's fast enough to give some good action to these lures.
Another fish on here, the green humdinger.
It's been pretty productive so far.
Yeah, it's a good color for Bug Lake and the water clarity.
There he is.
Hey, just a little another guy here. We'll probably kick him off the side of the boat.
Good looking trout.
Oop, rod one's off the clip.
Oh, there he goes, jumping back there. These things are a ball. I mean, fighting on this rod too, it's great. I mean, it's got enough power, but the tip is so sensitive. And this thing just pulled it right off the clip. Crust fryer again, crippler. Oh, there he's taking a little bit. Probably be a keeper. I don't know how big he is, but probably in that 16-inch range.
Usually when they're jumping like that, they're pretty decent.
Yeah. There's a long ways back there. I mean, that's kind of the key. Just get away from the boat. Especially when these fish are so shallow. There you go. Nice thing about this, at 9 foot rod, especially with the offshore brackets, get around the motor. There's a lot of room for you to be able to work this fish and not get jammed up with all this extra space. Yeah, he's a nice fish for sure.
Good rainbow.
Another keeper. Beautiful fish too.
We're on Lake Davis with Mark Christoffel and Adam Birdwell, and on this morning it's all about cripplers and humdingers smeared with trophy trout bait sauce.
Another keeper. So this is the lure that just caught that fish. It's the Crush Fire crippler. See, it's gold back, and then it's got that iridescent kind of tape on there. It throws out a little bit of pink, but primarily orange. This, about a week ago, wasn't doing a whole lot for us. And then yesterday, all day long, it just lit up. So we're going to do a little Nightcrawler bait wax once again, and then some Procure Trophy Trout bait sauce. We're just putting it right back on the back there. And... they seem to like it. There it is. Right at the shelf.
We jumping. Oh, he's a dancer.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Right by, oh, I think he just popped.
Oh.
He earned it. He did about 5 jumps in 2 seconds. Earned his freedom.
Yeah, that was pretty cool.
Another fish on. Green humdinger is smoking him.
Yeah, it was a good choice of colors there.
Alright, a little alligator roll.
Oh, not again.
Yep, man. Alright, fish on. Green humdinger strikes again. Yeah, I was losing a few fish and, you know, had a pretty noodly rod on. So I switched over to something with a little bit more backbone, a little stiffer tip. Try to keep a little more pressure on the fish. Hook set a little bit better as well. So see if my theory holds true, but so far so good. Feels like a pretty good fish too.
Is that brown?
I think so. Fighting like a rainbow.
Nice fish.
He's a good one. Not quite ready.
Oh,
oh man, big run. Fun fish here, he's strong. Man, taking more drag. It's a brute.
Yeah, it's a good fish. He's still got some left, but we'll see.
Yeah, try not to over drag him, but. Okay. Yeah, that's a good one there.
Yeah, that's
boys.
A good one.
Hey, look at that. As soon as it took the pressure off him, away he went. But he's in the net.
Oh, oh, there we go.
Yet to jump. It's very unlike the Davis rainbow.
Saving his energy for that.
He's waiting, yeah.
Back 10 feet.
Alright, getting a little closer here.
fish.
All right, buddy. He's almost ready. Doing a couple alligator rolls. Oh, my net man got a phone call. All right, here we go. Coming in. All right, that's a chunk. Got myself another line, too.
That's a good fish.
Yeah, looks like I got your homie.
Hey everybody, I hope you're enjoying this week's episode from Lake Davis, where we're getting some beautiful rainbow trout with guide Mark Christoffel and Adam Birdwell. Now, we're using, two of the rods we're using anyway, are the 9.5 foot Angler West trout and kokanee rods. I've been working on this style of rod for close to a decade now with several different manufacturers, and I couldn't be happier with where we are with them now. These are 2-piece 9.5 foot rods with the green tips so you can see them, composite handles, and composite construction. Super strong, light, durable, with an awesome parabolic bend, and at 9.5 feet, that's giving you the ability to reach around your downriggers and your offshore brackets and so forth, and have some control over bigger fish, and control over any fish, really. In this episode, what happened was we were losing a lot of fish. Now, you might not see so many fish being lost in the episode because there's just no time to show all that, but I noticed that the fish caught with these rods tended to come in the boat more than the fish caught on the shorter, more noodly type of rods. And that really made me happy because I've been working on these rods for a long time. I'm very proud of them. So these are the Angler West 9.5 foot kokanee trolling rods. And they're awesome. Now, one thing too that happened in this episode was that the bite on the Crippler and the Humdinger died on us about 10 o'clock. And I said, hey, throw on a Nightmare. This is a Nightmare wedding ring by Max Lure. It's a special color that I have them put together for me. And guess what? Boom, 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 boom. 5 or 6 fish right away. It was awesome. The Nightmare really came through. Black and white's one of those colors that it either works really well or it's not gonna work at all. And there's only one way to find out. More often than not, they're gonna work really well. Now let's go back to Lake Davis and see if we can't finish out the day with some more beautiful rainbow trout.
It's been a fantastic morning, but now the bite has slowed, so it's time to change our tactics.
So the bite slowed down a little bit. I'm opting to go down, put a little wiggle hoochie with a worm trailer. It's gonna have some great action back there, and hopefully, you know, we're now looking to kind of aggravate these fish and make them mad, get them to strike out of aggression. The chop on the water, the traditional offerings that we had before just aren't cutting it. So hopefully this will create a little chaos for them down there. It's early May right now. I tend to target these fish early spring. They do have a copepod issue out here. The fishing can still be good in the summertime, but you get a lot of weeds. A lot of people decide to go fly fishing and that sort of thing. Trolling becomes a little bit more difficult. And then come in the fall time, it's almost all float tubes, fish and flies, casting into weeds, that sort of thing. The trolling game though, if you want to do this and what we're doing, it's definitely an early May ball game. You know, I think we've been fishing this for 3 weeks now, and when we first got in here, water temp was 47. It's 50 now, which is just prime time for these fish. So
all right, fish on the wiggle hoochie. Definitely bumped up the aggression on the presentation, and paid off. They seem to be a little more lethargic, so wanted to create a little more disturbance in the water.
That's a nice fish.
And there you have it. This here is a green splatterback wiggle hoochie with the UV bill on a bright sunny day. It's just an awesome choice. Creates lots of flash, brings extra attention to the lure along with the vibration. Contrast, light, and vibration. It's the perfect combo. This rod here just went off to, ooh, taking big drag there on the Nightmare wedding ring. But the fourth bite we've had on it, and this one is stuck, feels like. And he really took some nice drag there. The water is definitely a bit murky, not great clarity, and so that big black thumper blade on that and the white beads, great contrast, really good and visible. Rod 4 is off the clip. We got a dancer.
That also is a good visible lure with the green humdinger. This one was tipped with just a little bit of night crawler, split in half. He feels like a stud. Man, this guy's just solid.
He's got this on an 8-ounce chartreuse humdinger. Bright lure. It's been pegging them all day, and I mean, we've got a jumper back here. Both of these fish here. I don't know what we're gonna do quite yet, but.
Well, if you can hand me the net, I could probably try to one arm him. Always up for a good challenge.
But this one's just peel and drag on me.
Oh yeah.
This one's a smaller one.
Man, these rainbows are fun.
Net this guy, this one's a smaller one. Probably gonna release him both sides.
Oh yeah. That rainbow on the nightmare wedding ring there.
Okay. Go.
Oh yeah. Just over 20. Yeah, so we switched over to this nightmare wedding ring here behind this Max Sling Blade. It's about a 2.5 foot leader. Bite slowed down a little bit, so we actually back speed off a little, put a little night crawler on this double hook, and just the contrast between the black and the white beads and the little extra scent with the night crawler really seemed to do the ticket. About 4 or 5 bites came real fast on this in the last half an hour.
Thanks for making the time to watch today's episode, and I hope it was time well spent. Now, if we can help you out with your own fishing, be sure to stop into the Angler West store in Woodland, Washington. And remember, without our sponsors, there is no show. So please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.